Good afternoon, Mr. Jade. Long time no see. How are you?
I'm good. Good. Thanks for having me.
We've talked a couple times on the podcast. You've always been really helpful for me with that, and I appreciate it. And we've done quite a few deliverances together too. I haven't counted, but I would think it's at least 20 or so. I don't know.
Yeah, it's probably more than that. I don't know. It seems
Could be
like it's,
more. Yeah, which is mainly you bringing people. Today we're going to address sort of the controversial subject. And I wanted to introduce by saying I've noticed in churches that typically there's two subjects that if I open my mouth and say something, someone's going to get mad, or there's going to be like an awkwardness in the room. One of the subjects is politics, and the other subject is LGBTQ. And so I guess we're just going to go for it. We did a thing on politics like a month ago. And I totally passed the buck and had my daughter-in-law speak that Sunday, and she did an awesome job. I'm really glad I did. And then for Sunday, I'm passing the buck as well, and having you speak on the subject of LGBTQ. Speak the truth and bring a blessing. Maybe make some people mad, but it's okay because you'll be leaving right after that. And I'll just be like, I don't know who that guy is. He just wandered in here. I don't know how he got it up here. You know, when you hear the letters LGBTQ, what does that mean to you?
For me, it's a manufactured narrative. And I say this because I used to be gay, and when I first came out in this lifestyle, it was just LG and eventually B, maybe, and that's all it was. They were adding in more people in this into this category to be inclusive. And you had to be okay with all of it because we're all family and we're all kind of on the same mission for inclusivity. And at first we were all okay with that, those of us who were in the lifestyle. And then we realized that as it got more progressive and they started adding in these other letters and a plus sign and they even had the Q, which is for questioning, it opened it to a lot of things that a lot of us weren't okay with, that we didn't understand, that we were being told that we needed to ex just accept blindly, really. And so even in that culture and that lifestyle, we were all kind of searching and scrambling to see what these other letters and what these other lifestyles meant and what they represented and if we wanted to even be a part of them or not.
Yeah.
And most of us realized we didn't want anything to do with this overall narrative that they're trying to not only push on us, but push on the culture.
It's
Meant to divide is really, it's not inclusive
yeah.
at all.
Us versus them kind of a thing. Yeah, the opposite of inclusion, which is ironic since that's the stated goal. Hey gang, I am at Costco in Thornton today meeting a friend for lunch, and I'm asking an interesting question. The letters LGBTQ, what do they mean to you? That's the first question. The second one is, how do you think the typical religious person feels, or what does those letters mean to that person? So, wish me luck. Right. What's your name?
My name is Susanna Mejia.
So thank you for helping me, Susanna. I'm Alex.
You're welcome.
First question, five letters, LGBTQ, what does that mean?
It means, well, it represents quite a few things,
yeah.
Including freedom, what really is democracy to me. To me, that means freedom. I am not in LGBTQ, but I respect and honor all those people, anyone who makes any choice. I feel the same way about religion as well.
What's your name?
John Schussler.
John, thanks for helping me. My name's Alex. So, two questions this week. First one is five letters, LGBTQ. What does that mean to you?
Nothing really.
You know what they are? Or?
No.
Oh, it's the letters that represent like the sexual freedom community, like lesbian,
oh, okay.
Gay,
gotcha.
Bi.
I remember that.
So when you hear that, what does that mean to you?
Just a different type of person.
Yep. Okay. What's your name?
I go by Squid.
Squid?
Yes, sir.
And my name is Alex. Thanks
nice
for helping me, Squid. Two questions today. They're different every week, but five letters, LGBTQ.
Mm-hmm.
What does that mean to you?
It means community. I'm from Oklahoma, and
okay.
I am a queer person. And out in Oklahoma, it was very hard to find community.
Yeah.
So whenever I moved out here, like that label became a place that I knew was safe for me. It was a place that I would be welcomed.
When I lived in Colorado, it was the thing was straight but not narrow.
Oh.
And that was a
I've never heard that.
Pink triangle.
Okay.
And I had a button and, you know.
Yeah. Well, you sort of take me into the second question, which is the same five letters. How do you think religious people generally feel or view those five letters?
I think it might depend not only on their religion, but also on whether or not they've ever had any personal experience.
Yeah, like a family
with
member.
Someone, a family member, yes. Yeah. My brother-in-law is gay. I have two trans nieces,
yeah.
Nephews.
Right.
So, you know, it makes a difference.
Yeah. For the average religious person, what do you think it means to them? Those five letters, that designation.
Probably pretty bad.
Okay. Can you expand on that bad? And
just that probably a religious person doesn't think of those things being proper.
What would you say those five letters would mean to a religious person?
I mean, it's going to be super corny, but it's the same letters, same as the five letters, J-E-S-U-S, right? It's love. It's love. True Christians, true religious people, true people who believe in God, love their fellow man because they're perfect. God made them in that image. And you're going to hate them for that? No. So it should mean love. Whether or not that's community for them or not.
Yeah.
Like, it's just their people.
Yeah. There's LGBTQ. What does it mean to the average religious person, would you say?
I feel like it's someone who's further away from God, and a lot of times it's brings on higher judgment or a condemnation than other sin. And there's something to it that just really ignites division.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe the spirit of pride, I mean, that's kind of what the spirit of pride is for. It's to show us that, you know, we're better than other people, or our lifestyle is primacy over other people's. And
yeah,
it's just another way to divide.
Are you ready, Boo? Start walking.